Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is Nikolai.
And I'd wish you'd stay away from my vodka.
Before we get started, I want to give a huge shout out to my awesome sponsors over at Astro Gaming. They just released the brand new Call of Duty League collection for your Astro A40 TR headset. You could represent your favorite team or the Call of Duty League by picking up these speaker tags over at astrogaming.com. You can also learn more about the Astro A40 TR headset by clicking the link in the description below. I have an unboxing video and an overview of what this headset's all about. In this video today, there's a bunch of topics that I'd like to talk about, but the first one is probably the most important since it's time sensitive as it stands. But as of today, on the 26th, this issue still has not been fixed. There is an event going on called the Hunt for Adler. This event works a little bit differently than the Outbreak event we had a couple of months ago, where there were challenges for both Warzone and Black Ops Cold War that needed to be completed all together in order to get that main item at the end. You don't have to do that this time around. Within the Hunt for Adler, there are three challenges for Black Ops Cold War and three challenges for Warzone, each one of those challenges giving their own items, but you only have to complete three for any single game in order to get the main item, which of course is this skin called Tortured and Rescued. Now, here is the unfortunate part about these challenges. Number one, it's only available for a week, so we have 3 days left. That's the time constraint. Number two, the Warzone challenges are not working for everybody. Some people have been lucky enough to get them completed, but many of us have not been able to do them because it's just not working. What you're supposed to be able to do is drop into the three locations, whether that's the summit, the farmland, or the factory, pick up an Adler contract. You then get the objective to go find Adler's equipment. And then once you open up that final box, it says that you found a clue. And I think that's where it's supposed to end, but then again, I could be completely wrong because it's broken. Maybe a clue is supposed to come out of the box and send you to one final location, I don't know. All I do know is, because these challenges are not working, there is a calling card, a weapon charm, and an emblem that are unobtainable for many players out there. If you haven't jumped into Black Ops Cold War, I'm making this as a PSA to simply tell you, if you want to get that Tortured and Rescued skin, I highly suggest doing so and going and getting those challenges done. Black Ops Cold War has a free multiplayer weekend right now, which means you are able to jump in even if you don't own this game. I'm assuming that this event will in fact get extended, that way people will be able to actually earn the in-game items as soon as a fix goes live. The good news about that is Raven is already aware that there's an issue. They're currently investigating why players aren't able to complete this, but we haven't had any updates since 3 days ago when the event first went live. So I would assume that it's going to be coming soon, and like I said, since the event's supposed to be ending in a couple of days, I would just recommend jumping into the Black Ops Cold War multiplayer just in case. You never know what's going to happen, but due to the fact that you can't unlock the in-game items in Warzone, I would assume that they are going to be extending this in some way, shape, or form. While we're on the topic of limited time events, there will be another one coming up starting on Thursday, and this time it's coming in the form of our second Gunfight tournament. It really does seem like they're trying to keep these going every week or every other week, which is very surprising. At least it seems like the team is trying to stick to some sort of schedule, which is good. Just as a reminder, Gunfight tournaments provide rewards like calling cards, charms, stickers, and at the end, a weapon blueprint. If you'd like to see everything that you've unlocked so far, head to your challenges tab, go down to Gunfight Tournaments, and you'll see exactly where you placed for the first tournament. With this, you'll be able to see upcoming ones, and it seems like they have 12 planned for the remainder of the year. I don't know about anybody else out there, but seeing this and knowing that you get a check mark for completing that specific tournament really does drive me to want to win that tournament. That way, I don't miss out on any item. And after looking at this and seeing all those check marks, it's going to be a very satisfying feeling. I'm not sure how many of you saw my video from a couple of days ago where I reviewed Yamantau and Diesel, our brand new multiplayer maps for Season 3, but we have a small change coming to the playlist starting tomorrow, and that is Diesel will no longer be a 3v3 playlist. It's going to be turned into a 6v6 playlist, allowing us to play things like Team Deathmatch, Domination, Kill Confirmed, and Hardpoint, all on diesel with 12 players. It's definitely going to be a different feeling map when there are more players on it. I'm very excited to see how it does. But one of my biggest gripes with the map as it sits in a 3v3 playlist, it just felt kind of bare bones. It felt like there wasn't much action happening. So hopefully 12 players will change that up. I'll have gameplay and of course, maybe I'll even give you my updated thoughts when that happens. Oh yeah, and I wanted to mention one more thing. With this playlist update, Sticks and Stones is staying. It's not actually being removed or rotated out. It's still going to be there for the next week. So if you were still playing Sticks and Stones and enjoying yourself, you'll be able to do so still. I would imagine that this will be one of those core game modes that ends up staying in the game. It's one of those party modes that a lot of people seem to enjoy, and I would imagine that it's here to stay, hopefully forever. Now, if only we can see a return of wager matches. I'm not sure how it would work now because there's no in-game currency, but maybe we can wager up our own XP values. You put in 10,000 XP, and maybe you can win 50 to 100,000 out if you end up coming in first place. Hey, it's just an idea. It would be fun, though. I know this might be big news and a shocker to everybody, but the store is going to be getting an update in Black Ops Cold War. However, this one is going to be receiving some more highly anticipated bundles that people have been looking forward to, including more anime waifus and the addition of Knight. So Knight is the duo to Wraith. They stormed Mount Yamato together, and of course, they destroyed it together. As of right now, we don't have any images of this particular bundle. What we do know is this bundle will include a brand new companion animal called the Snowhawk and a finishing move called Bird of Prey. Of course, this means now if you have that finishing move equipped to your operator, you will also see that bird flying alongside you in the pregame lobby. So similar to the Plaguehound or the dog, you can have them walking right alongside you. So that's pretty cool. This bundle is also going to give you an AR blueprint, an LMG blueprint, the Operator Knight, of course, and finally an animated calling card, animated emblem, and a weapon charm. I'm really hoping that the finishing move isn't like a copy and paste of the crow or the raven pecking the eyes out of a player like we had back in Modern Warfare, but only time will tell. We'll see very soon. Another operator outfit that's coming through is called Tree Python. This is going to be part of the In the Sticks bundle. Tree Python was shown pretty heavily in the Season 3 trailers and promotional material. People were saying they really wanted this one. We know now that this outfit is for Naga, and it's going to include a Tombstone Soda weapon charm and another finishing move called Splitting Hairs featuring a Kukri. This particular blade, by the way, is something that we're going to be seeing a lot of over the next couple of weeks, so I would assume that it only makes sense eventually it will come as a full weapon to use in Black Ops Cold War. There is a handful of finishing moves from Season 3 that seem to use the Kukri, so I find that kind of pleasant because that's a really nice looking blade. The next bundle that people have been clamoring for ever since it leaked a couple of days ago is the Anime Pop Stars bundle, which features an AUG, an FFAR blueprint, and a pop star truck with mounted turret. So as always, guys, if you plan on picking up anything from the shop throughout the next week, please consider using my creator code, which is Prestige in all caps. Doing so goes directly to supporting me and my family. I truly appreciate you coming out to this video here today. If you enjoyed it, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Alrighty, folks, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.